What?
You would imagine that the set would have a decent advantage as we got some action here.
Yep, time winder comes down. There's the flash after Bono. Very aggressive, but I don't know whether he necessarily wins this. As Kaney's going to jump forward. Faller still wants this fight. Spear is going to connect as Smeb is going to come down as well. Kaney still waiting in the brush, and Smeb just grabs the kill. I don't know what they were expecting. There's the flash facebreaker as Ixu finally turns up. Bono going to be taken down. It is chaos in the jungle. A double kill for Smeb, though, as now it's him versus Ixu, and I think we all know how this one goes. The flash to follow. The rep buff is going to stop Ixu from doing anything. Smeb waiting for that E, but he is going to be able to find it, and there it is. Triple kill to start the game. Flash forward from Trigger. He's exhausted as now aiming is being spotted by the Hawkshot. I don't think we're going to have another rocket grab as Tucson intelligently is going to block. Does come in as, Trigger's just running away. Smeb teleported down. He wants 4 kills before 5 minutes. This game is just absolutely off the rails, and it's all to the benefit of Smith.
Early and often, as you can see, Flawless is like, I see enemy champion, I go on enemy champion.
Look at this flash.
Yeah, this flash, I'm like, whoa! And you see, Kaney's able to rotate first, which I think is part of the reason why he's going so aggressive. So starts this 2-on-2, but they're so deep that Smeb gets there first, and then eventually Yukal comes over. And then we actually get Kaney popping off here, able to get 2 kills on the set. I love how he kites into the brush to play with some of the LOS. And in the end of the day, though, it is going to be a massive win to the side of KT as Smeb picked up double buffs. And also 4 kills in total as he joined in on this fight, Max.
Yeah, exactly. Aiming tried to get a cleanse working out, but you can't cleanse a knockup. It's not a thing that you can really do anything about. As this was just great by Tucson to block so that rocket grab didn't land. Now with a giant minion wave as well as 2 people versus 1, Mia was definitely dead and Trigger was trying to escape and just leave his support to die, but he's also going to fall. Bono would have landed that spear as well. As we go back to live, and there's more fighting, of course. Trigger down to sub 100 as Tucson Flash misses yet another Q, much like he did on his Lux earlier on. Bit unfortunate, Peacemaker barely scratches.
He was able to get back towards that lane. Smeb, of course, teleporting down.
Tucson's in the mid lane. That's a flash facebreaker into the showstopper. Tucson out of position now. He's a very squishy Brad who'll take a magical journey. We'll see whether he does have the cosmic binding. He does, but misses the wall onto Flawless, and a phase dive will be able to grab that.
But it looked like they were trying to set up a play onto Yukal, but then they saw the squishy Bard. So that was even better.
Here comes Flawless. Another flash as the arrow is going to be flashed out of. Yukal coming down. But there's another rocket grab that's going to land as aiming's just going to be obliterated. Tempered Fate way too late. No way that Tucson can do that, as I'm not even sure why aiming was there. Maybe coming over to try and grab this red buff that Bono's going to secure, but he may die.
Oh, that's weird.
That's okay.
Do absolutely nothing. But if you get one huge hook, I mean, you could change the entire game as, straight up flash hook there, as it didn't look like aiming.
Okay. 80 carries do like. Now Yukal just bouncing around here on the bottom side. Gets his face broken for a little bit of time, but...
Smeb,
good sidestep there. Avoids the rocket grab from the nether. Flawless going to get stunned up there by Tucson, but not a lot of follow-up, because that's a great spear. Arrow going to be traded, but it's not going to hit Shelly. Aiming comes in. I think the Ash building in execution is just cheekily after the Runa. It's a great way of getting it. There's the arrow, but Smeb, he's already engaged and got out again. That is going to buy enough space here for KT to disengage and take down the turret. 53 seconds. The setup begins. The Smeb cycloning already onto Ixu. The Narbar is going to be built up as that's a great stun into the wall. Facebreaker onto multiple members. As Aiming now comes down, grabs that kill, and unfortunately, it looks like Solo One Prince are just too far behind. That is a Chrono Break used defensively. Good abduct from Yukal, who won't land the Chain Lash for the extra damage, and Flawless looks like he will escape. There's the Super Soaker, and Yukal wanting to get aggressive, wanting to stay in position. Cyclone almost back off cooldown as Parallel Convergence not going to find any stuns or anything. As Mia's going to get trapped, another Tempered Fate will land. Will he have the rocket grab? He does! Ooh. And it is going to land onto Tucson, who flashes away immediately. Yukal now with a Narbar of his own, looking to see whether he can get some stuns into the wall. Kaney going to get just melted down by Aiming, who's looking for those autos. But no, not going to be able to get there. But into the back line goes the Sylas, and he will be able to eradicate the Rift.
Get to the back line onto the Caitlyn as here we go again.
Yep, there's an arrow. It is going to land onto Yukal, who just Chrono Breaks for damage on top of Solo on Prince. Now a teleport right into the middle of them. Smeb comes through. Ixu gets a big ultimate, but unfortunately the wallets are too heavy and the Kingslayer keeps Yukal alive. Kaney's just doesn't really matter. Kaney and Trigger, both of them dead alongside Ixu. Now Smeb fighting Flawless and the Cyclone comes out. Looks like he's just going to die. Dissipate, yeah.
Dissipate, that's the word I was looking for.
Yeah, pull it down.
Yeah. Yukal's going ham.
Yep, he is going to be able to grab an ultimate there. Chrono Breaks back. Mir and Flawless taking so much damage. Yukal's still alive, by the way. Bono going to grab the kill first up. Flawless in trouble now as well, who doesn't have his ultimate anymore. And KT are going to take down this inhibitor and possibly look for more. Everyone on Solo One Prince, apart from Trigger, needing to go back to that fountain. And KT really are putting on a clinic. I know it's against Solo One Prince, but certainly a good look for these guys. And this inhibitor going to go down. Smeb diving into the back line. Nothing Solo One can do. Second Cyclone goes out. That'll be the end of Flawless. Big haymaker, and the Showstopper comes through as well as he does get Yukal into the fountain. That's exactly what they want. This was their plan. Get them towards the fountain where they've got rocket grabs and Showstoppers.
To grab. Just waiting for some super creeps to head towards the base, so they can guarantee this outer turret. Oh my god, Kaney taking so much damage from Aiming. He's just walking on forward.
Oh!
The ulti has to go golden. Smeb gonna be pushed underneath the turret. And there's the GA. Can the rest of the team actually save them? As he flashes out, the Tempered Fate was beautiful by Tucson. Mia limping away from the team fight, but he will get back to the fountain. The last inhibitor will fall down. As Solo One Prince, I mean, they're not dead, but their base is very close to it. Aiming in trouble. Flawless may have overextended, but the Chrono Break is going to be there. He'll survive.
Yeah. Looks like they're going to go for the flashy end here. Looking to stack up their kills.
Yep, Smeb's teleporting in. He's got the home guard. Big stun will land. And there's a Showstopper out as Bono's just going to pounce on top of Kaney, but goes golden, so avoids a bit of that damage. Doesn't seem to matter as you saw the Gnar try and do what he could. Flawless grabs the kill onto Yukal, but they trade it for all of their damage. And there's the ulti. Unfortunately, no way to get the Parallel Convergence out faster. So Flawless will fall down for that ace in the hole. And now, with this parade of super creeps, KT will finally end this game at around 33 minutes.
Yep, they have done it. Kaney, they're trying to take him down first, but there's way too many
golden
minions.
Sure.
Way too many minions. GG!
I wanted him to be golden by the time the game ended. But yeah, congratulations to KT. They will win game number one. They're looking for a